Hello students, welcome to online computer classes. Myself Dr. Kajal Rai and this is a class for Python. Today we learn about the loops in Python. We already had understand what is while loop. Now it's time to learn about the for loop, which is the most important loop in Python or any other programming language. It is very important. First of all, we have to know what is iteration. Iteration is the repetition of statements. It repeats the execution of statements in a code, as I told you. For example, suppose you have to repeat two or three statements again and again in your program. Then this is called iteration, where you use the loops to repeat that sequence of instructions. It is very useful for solving many programming problems. Iteration and conditional execution form the basis for any algorithmic construction. Now it's time for for loop. What is for loop? A for loop is also a repetition control structure that will allow you to efficiently write a loop or a sequence of instructions that need to be executed or repeated at a specified number of times. In the while loop, you do not know when the execution will end up, or you use the loop while loop when you don't know exactly how many number of times the statements will going to repeat. But in a for loop, you already know how many times the sequence or the statements are going to repeat. This is the main difference between while loop and for loop. The for loop provides a syntax where the following information is provided. For example, what are the things needed? As we studied that in while loop, a condition statement is there, the while keyword is there, and many other things. Exactly in the for loop also, some things are very important. For example, a condition. It is Boolean condition, whether it is in while loop or for loop, because it always answers you in true or false. A condition can be a true or a false. It answers only in these two cases. That is why it is called Boolean condition. Then the next important thing is the initial value of the counting variable. For example, if you initialize a variable, suppose I equals to 0 or I equals to 1, and then repeat certain number of instructions, whether up till I is less than 5 or less than 10, whatever the condition you choose. Then the incrementation of that counting variable is also very important. If you do not increment I, then the loop will go on repeating it at infinite number of times and the program collapses. So that's why it is very important to increment that counting variable. This is the syntax of for loop in Python. First we have to write the for keyword, then the variable which you are taking for incrementing or initializing the loop. This variable is the counting variable. Then in you have to write and range. Range is a function where you specified how many number of times that loop will be executed, or you have to give certain condition. For example, for I in 1 to 10 or 1 to 13 or 15 up to 15, then you repeat certain number of statements. Here the colon is very important for any for loop or while loop or any if condition also. This colon is very important. You have to give the colon after these looping constructs. After that, when you put the colon, then the statements whatever you write inside the for loop should be indented a little right hand side than the for loop, and up till the statements you intended on the same conditions, then only those statements are repeated in the while loop. You don't put curly braces as like C++ or Java. Here you always intend the statements some right hand side. So this is the syntax for the for loop, and this is the flowchart of for loop, where the start is the thing where you start the loop. then the item for sequence, for example, if there are more items, matlab more number of statements you need to repeat, then the condition is not satisfied, then you do it, repeat the statements, execute the statement, and if the condition is false, then the end will be there. This is the flow chart. Now let's start with the Jupyter notebook. Here is the example of prime number, in which first the num is a variable. Here we are taking the number from the user by giving the statement enter any number. Here I use the input function. Input function is used to take the input from the user. We are not specifying the input directly. Because we are not specified with any constant variable, we are using the dynamic conditions where the user can enter the input. But whatever input the user entered will be in string format. So we have to convert it into integer format by using int function over here. I already told you about some of these cases. We already had done previous videos, previous lectures you have seen, where we use input function and also the int function, where we convert the string into integer. If you don't know about this, please go through the previous videos of Python and you will have a look of that and you can understand it very easily. Then after that, after taking the input from the user, we use the for loop. Here for loop, for is given, then I is the conditional, I is the counting variable, then in keyword is there, then range is there. Range is a function where we range from 2 comma num minus 1. Here the range starts from the 2 number. That means I should be 2, start from 2, and num minus 1. That means we are not repeating, we are not extending to num variable. We are taking the one less number than num. Then colon is there. This is the syntax for the for loop. Then the statements, all these in the for loop is intended some right hand side. Then an if condition is also we are giving. We already studied about the if and else if and elif conditional statements, how we can give it this. We already have the knowledge of this. We already studied about this. If you are having any problem, please go to the previous videos where we already told about the conditional statements. Here num, we are dividing num by I and taking the modulus operators we are using, because we are taking the remainder. If the remainder is 0, which is necessary for the prime number to find out, then we are printing the statement. If the remainder is equal to 0, then the number is not prime. That means it is fully divisible by any number in between this range. As we know, prime number is what? Prime number is the number which is only divisible by 1 or itself, not other than any number. That is why we are ranging this from 2, not 1. And we are taking one number less than the entered number. So that in between the numbers, if that number is divisible, fully divisible by any number between this range and the remainder comes to 0, that means that number is not prime. Otherwise it is prime. And if this condition is met, then we use the break statement. Break statement is used because we find out that the number is not prime, then unnecessary going through the loops is not compulsory until the end of the loop. Otherwise we will go whenever the loop ends, if that is not prime. We repeat these number of statements, specified number of times. Then we use the else. If this is not going to happen, that means the number is not fully divisible by any number, then the number is prime. Suppose, now let's run this by using the shift plus enter key. We are running this. Now enter any number. Suppose we are entering 22. We know that this is not prime because 22 is divisible by 11, by 2. Like this. So this is not prime number. Now suppose we are dividing any number 7. 7 is not divisible by any number. That is why it is a prime number. Again, one more example we take. 81 is not prime because it comes in the table of 9. So it is not prime, and if we are taking 89, it is a prime number. It is not divisible by any other number. So this is the example of for loop, which is a very important loop in Python. I hope you understand it. Thank you very much.